Let's start with the first topic for this session. Now we have seen the cost of capital. How do you compute the minimum return to be given to an investor? Now when we want funds from the public, the certain thing is minimum return we need to give it to them. So they give us capital. That's what we saw under cost of capital. Okay, you know now how to find the return to be given to investor, but how you decide how much should be equity, how much should be preference, how much should be debentures? For example, if I need 10 crores, how will I decide? How much should I raise to equity? How much do I raise to debentures? What should be the amount part, right? So in capital structure, we compute as the proportions. Now before starting up capital structure, let us do a small illustration to make you understand why capital structure is more important. Now capital structure just focuses on one thing, to decide the proportion or the various sources of finance. Means how much debt, how much equity, how much preference and how much retained earnings should be there in your capital structure. Now when you do any decision of finance, keep the objective of finance very clear. The objective of finance is that the shareholders' wealth should be maximized. Remember the first session of this module when we started up, we said whatever you do, focus on the goal of finance, and the goal of finance is wealth maximization. The shareholders' wealth should increase. And how will you increase the shareholders' wealth? By increasing the market price of share, right? So we're keeping the same objective in mind. Whatever source we raise money from, at the end, shareholders' value should maximize. Now, so we'll do a small illustration to make it clear. Now, in this illustration, I'll give you three sources of finance, like debentures, retained earnings, B preference or B equity. So among various sources of finance, what do you think? What is your perspective? From what source, when you raise funds, will shareholders' wealth be maximized? Now different students may come with different answers. Some will say when you have more equity shares in your capital structure, the shareholders' wealth will increase more. Some may say that when you have more preference or more retained earnings or more debentures, then the shareholders' wealth might increase. So if you see, different people have different perspective. But you'll be surprised when you see this illustration is that the shareholders' wealth is actually maximized when you have more fixed interest bearing securities. When you have more securities like who are more fixed in nature, more obligatory in nature, you'll be surprised to see that EPS becomes the highest in that case. The shareholders' wealth is maximized in that case mostly. I'm not saying always, there's exception to this rule as well. When capital structure, when you see the shareholders' wealth will be maximized when you have more debentures in your capital structure. Second, when you have more preferences. And last, your shareholders' wealth is maximized when you have more equity. Now, how does it happen? If you say if debentures lead to more market price of a share, why does it happen? Let us do a small illustration why certain things happen. Keeping your focus, we want to go and raise money through that source in which shareholders' wealth is maximized. Our goal of finance is very, very clear. Now, keeping a goal of finance, let us do this small illustration. Let us see why capital structure is so, so important. Now, for example, as you can see, ABC company is currently in all equity capital structure consisting of 15,000 equity shares of 100 each. So you already know there is an existing equity share company. The shares are 15,000 shares and one share is for 100 each. The management is planning to raise another 25 lakhs to finance a major program of expansion. So the company is more 25 lakhs and it already has equity shares in its capital structure. Now see, there are three options for the company to raise money. The first option is that the company raises money only through equity shares. So to raise 25,000 equity shares of 100 each. Second option for the company is to raise money through debenture. That is 25,000 8% debentures of 100 each. The third option for the company to raise money is 25,000 8% preference shares of 100 each. Now, there are three options how they can get the money as. Now, we will go for that source in which our EPS is the highest. That is, the market price per share becomes the highest or earnings available to a shareholder becomes the highest. Moreover, they're giving you EBIT is 8 lakh, tax rate is 40%, you have to find out the EPS. Now, in this illustration, you have seen EBIT is given to you. And we'll start with the EBIT and you know how profits are to be distributed. Now, when you see profits are to be distributed, you start with EBIT. What is EBIT? Earnings before interest and tax. This is the profit which is ready for distribution. Now, what is EBIT? Sales minus cost of goods sold gives you gross profit. Gross profit minus operating expenses, you add up any operating incomes, gives you EBIT. Right? Now, this profits needs to be distributed. Now, how will you distribute EBIT as such as? Out of earnings before interest and tax, whom we do we give the returns first? We give it to debenture holders or loan holders in the form of interest. So EBITL minus is the interest part first. So EBIT minus interest gives you how much? PBT, right? That is profit before tax. We know interest is tax deductible, so we'll minus is the tax part, which gives you profit after tax, right? Now profit after tax, next people whom do we give now? Interest holders we have given, or debenture holders we have given the form of interest. Interest is tax deductible, we get profit after tax. The next people we pay preference shareholders in the form of preference dividend. So from profit after tax we minus is the preference dividend. Remaining profit goes for distribution, and we call it as earnings available to equity shareholders. Now keeping this table handy, whatever you go for in finance, in this case as well, when profits are to be distributed, how much profits will maximize the shareholders' wealth? That profit plan I'll go for ahead. Now because that profit plan fulfills my goal of finance. Now you'll be surprised when you work out this illustration. When you have more fixed obligations in your capital structure, your earnings to the shareholders or EPS becomes the way is the highest. Now how does it happen, and then we'll discuss about it, why it is happening as such. For example, if you see EBIT is given to you as 8 lakhs, so whatever plan you go for, profits of the company will remain the same. So 8 lakhs in all the plans, whatever you take it forward. First people we give out of the EBIT is debenture holders in the form of interest. Now if you see in the first plan, there are no debenture holders, we're raising money through equity, so interest won't come. Second plan, we are raising money through debentures. How much you are raising? 25,000, 8% debentures of 100 each. So how much is the interest part? 25,000 into 100 into 8%, right? How much interest do we get? We get an interest of 2 lakhs, right? Continue it further. Third plan, you are raising money through preference shares. Preference shares also do not have interest, so there will be no interest in the third plan. What will you get is the profit before tax. Now in the first case it is how much? 8 lakh minus 3 lakh 20,000 gives you 4 lakh 80,000. Second plan gives you 3 lakh 60,000, and the third plan gives you 4 lakh 80,000. So you have the profit after tax. The next person whom will you pay? We pay the preference shareholders in the form of preference dividend. If you see on the third plan you're raising money through preference shares, because in first plan you're raising money through equity, second plan you're raising money through debentures, on the third plan you're raising money through preference shares. How much is the preference dividend? 25,000 preference shares, 8% is the rate of dividend, and one share is for 100 each. So 25,000 into 100 into 8% gives you is 2 lakh. So minus preference dividend, 2 lakh in the third plan. Remaining profit, what do we get? Profit available to equity shareholders. In the first plan, how much do you get? 4 lakh 80,000. Second plan, how much you get? 3 lakh 60,000. And third plan, you get 2 lakh 80,000. So if you see, this is the full profit shareholders might take home. But if you ask how much is per shareholder earning, see, I may hold 10,000, you may hold 1,000 shares, our shareholding depend. So let us see how much per share value do we have. So how do we find out the earnings per share? To total earnings available to equity shareholders, divide the number of equity shares. In the first case, if you see, company is raising money through equity shares. How many equity shares is the company raising? For 25,000. Company currently has equity shares of how much? 15,000. So 15,000 equity shares, 25,000 new shares sum up to how much? 40,000. So number of equity shares in plan 1 is how much? 40,000. Go to plan 2. Company is raising only money through debentures. So the only existing equity shares you have, and existing equity shares we have is how much? 15,000. Go to plan 3. How much is the equity shares the company has? Preference shares the company wants to use. So company does not have any new equity shares. Company only has existing equity shares of how much? 15,000 again. So earnings divided by number of equity shares gives you earnings per share. In first case is how much? 4,80,000 divided by 40,000, which gives us 12 rupees. Second case, 3,60,000 divided by 50,000 gives 15,000 gives us 24 rupees. Third case, if you see, 2,80,000 divided by 15,000 gives us 18.67. So per share value, if you see, you get different in all the cases. But if you see, highest becomes in how much? Plan 2. Plan 2, your per share value is how much? 24. Why? Now if you notice over here, when you have more obligations in your capital structure, when you have more debentures in your capital structure, you can see per share value is the highest, that is 24. Second case you can see is under plan 3, it is 18.67. Now if you see, in this case you have preference shares in your capital structure. So when you have another fixed obligation, which is as comparatively less to debentures, you can see you have more EPS, and least EPS comes is under plan 1. Now according to finance, which we have studied as such, we should go to whatever plan in which our shareholders' wealth is maximized. That is the ultimate goal of finance we have seen. And over here, you see, ultimate goal of finance is met under plan 2, that is 24 rupees. But is it correct? Having more debentures in your capital structure also increases your liability. What happens 5-6 years down the line when you have to repay back these debentures? Ultimate drain on the financials of the company. So what do we do now? And this is what capital structure is all about. How do you raise appropriate amount of funds, keeping in mind a goal of finance and keeping in also mind the stability of the company? This is what we are going to study under capital structure, continuing with this illustration.